Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes. So, children, previous class we have discussed the solar system. Yeah, my children. So, numbers of planets we have learned in the solar system. How many planets are there in solar system, children? Yes, we have the 8 planets in the solar system. Pluto is a dwarf planet because it's a very small in size. Which planet is called the red planet, children? Tell me, which planet is called the red planet? Yes, Mars is called a red planet. Why it is red in color? Tell me, children, why it is red in color? Because presence of iron gas. Yeah, children, because presence of iron mineral. So this planet is looks like red in color. Which planet have the beautiful rings, 9 beautiful rings? Yes, Saturn. Saturn has the 9 beautiful rings. Yeah, no, children, which is the largest planet? Tell me, which is the largest planet in the solar system? Very good. Jupiter is the largest planet in the solar system. Which is the hottest planet? Which is the hottest planet in the solar system? Yes, Venus is the hottest planet in the solar system. And the smallest planet? Smallest, or we say the nearest planet? Yes, Mercury. Mercury is the closest or the smallest planet in our solar system. Yeah, children, the sun, closest star, it is our closest star, is about 150 million kilometers away from the earth. So we say the sun is the closest star. Sun is also called the star, no? Yes, because, but this star have the bright light. Very good, children. So this all the things we have discussed in the previous classes. Yeah, no, children, we discussed all the planets very detailed. Yeah, no, children, and one more thing, children. Venus is the only planet. Venus is the only planet that rotates itself from east to west. Rotate itself from east to west. And the Uranus, it rotates sideways. It rotates sideways, which means it exists nearly horizontally. Exists is nearly horizontally. Okay, children. Venus, see, it is a axis horizontally. Which planet? That is a Uranus. Venus rotate itself from east to west, and the Uranus rotate sideways. That means it is rotate nearly horizontally. Clear, children?
Yes.
Which planets are called the gas planet? Yes, Gen planets. Tell me, children. Yes, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and the Neptune. Yeah, the children. So in today's class, children, you are going to learn about the satellites. You are going to learn about the satellites. Which is the natural satellite of the Earth? Tell me, children. Which is the natural satellite of the Earth? Yes, Moon is the natural satellite of the Earth. Here you can see, this is our Earth. It's our Earth. And this is the Moon. It's a Moon. Moon is very small, children. Yes, it's a Moon. And here it is a sun. children, the earth has its own natural satellite that is called the moon. Clear children? Now one more time, listen. All the planets, they rotate around the sun. Only the satellites, they revolve around specific planet. Revolve around specific planets. Clear children? They revolve around the specific planet. Do hear? Satellite. Satellite revolve around specific planets only. And the moon is the natural satellite of the earth. Clear children? So here I will show you the some images. Just you can see. Okay children, here you can see. First is the sun, then earth, the next is moon. So moon is what here? Satellites which revolve around the earth planet only. Clear children? So all the planets in the solar system other than Mercury and Venus have one or more satellites revolving around them. Clear children? So this is about the satellite children. So next we'll see children, other heavenly bodies in the solar system. Other heavenly bodies in the solar system. First we discussed in the solar system, there are the 8 planets. One is a dwarf planet, that is a Pluto. And we also discussed about the satellites. So next we'll see the other heavenly bodies are also there in the solar system. So like asteroid, then comets, meteors. So these all are called the other heavenly bodies in the solar system. Okay children? So other heavenly bodies in the solar system.
Heavenly bodies in the solar system.
So in that, first is the dwarf planet. The first one is what here? What is the first one? Dwarf planet. Which is the dwarf planet, children? Yes. Pluto is called a dwarf planet. So like that, other planet also is there. They are called the dwarf planet. Only we know it that one dwarf planet, that is the Pluto only. But like that, other planets also are there, which is considered as a dwarf planet only. So first we discuss the dwarf planet. In 2006, children, astronomers decided to place the Pluto. They decided to go in the Pluto planet. So they wanted to find that whether it is a planet or any other heavenly bodies. So astronomers decide to go there. We have to go and do the research. Yes or no? So there is one small object after the Uranus. So we have to find whether that object is because of its small size, because of its small size, this planet is called a dwarf planet. Clear children? These are called the dwarf planet or planetoids. Clear children? So which planet is very small in size? Which planets are very small in size? They are called the dwarf planet. Clear children? So here I will show you the some images. Just you can see, these all planets are very small in size. Here you can see first one, Earth's moon to scale. See, the year is 2003, Pluto 1930, Haumea 1930, Makemake 1930. So these are called the dwarf planet. These are called the dwarf planet because it's small in size. And here children, this is small heavenly bodies that revolve around the sun. Next you have the asteroid. So all are clear? What is the dwarf planet? Which planets are small in size? Those are called the dwarf planet. Clear children? The next we see the asteroids. Next is the asteroids. So what is the asteroids? Asteroids are tiny celestial bodies. Tiny, very tiny celestial bodies that revolve around the sun. Let me show you. And here is the sun. Sun, and then here all the planets are there. Okay children, so here just you can see children, asteroids are tiny, they are very small in size, tiny celestial bodies that revolve around the sun. It's a revolve around the sun and that is called the asteroids belt. They are very small in size. Size than the dwarf planet. Just like I explained, the dwarf planet, which is the very small, smaller than dwarf planet. Now just to see, first only I have chose, the Pluto is a dwarf planet, which is a very small. So now just to imagine, smaller than dwarf planet, the asteroids are there, very smaller in size. These are found orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter. These are found orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter. So it is a Mercury. Yes, this is a Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars and the Jupiter. So it is the taking round. It is taking the orbiting. It is taking the orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter. It's like a very small, small rocks. Asteroid is what? Very, very, very small rocks. See here, children. This is called the asteroids. So these are found orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter, orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter and forming the belt, and that belt is called the asteroid belt. They are very small in size. They are very small rocks. Clear, children? So those are called the asteroids. What are they called? They are called the asteroid, children. So children, here you can see the asteroid belt, orbit of Jupiter. Orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter. Here you can see, no, this small celestial bodies. It's called the asteroids. See the shape. It is a small rocks. And these are very smaller than dwarf planet. So here just you can see how it looks. They are very small in size. See the size of the asteroids. And they revolve around the sun. These asteroids revolve around the sun. And these are founding the orbiting around the sun. And that is called the asteroid belt. You can see here. See the size, shape of the asteroid. There is a no shape only. See the how much small they are. They are orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter, children. Here you can see the clear image. See here asteroid belt, which is rotating between the Mars and Jupiter planet. See, this they are revolving around the sun only. This is called the asteroid belt. Here you can see. See the asteroid shapes. They had given the name. These are the largest asteroids. See here, children. How they looks? They looks like a small stones. Yana, children. See the asteroid near to the earth. See, children, asteroids. So children, this is about the asteroids. Okay, children. So remember, children, asteroids are very tiny celestial bodies that revolve around the sun. It's take the orbiting between the Mars and Jupiter. And this is called the asteroid belt. So next we'll see the next heavenly body in the solar system, that is the comets. Next one is the comets. The small body made of frozen gases. The small body made up of frozen gases, rock and dust. the small bodies made of frozen gases, rock and dust are called comets. Okay children, this is the definition of comets. The small bodies made of frozen gases, rock and dust are called comets. When a comet passes close, to the sun, first it is the, it is the frozen gases, it is the ice, it is a solid form, frozen gases, it is the ice in form. When this comet, passes, or we say when it comes close to the sun, then what will happen? When it is close to the sun, the intense heat of the sun, it heat up the comets and the gases are released, which is the frozen. Clear children, which gases are frozen when it comes closer to the sun, because of the heat of the sun, that frozen gases, it is started to release, and these gases form a tail. It is releasing the gases. So this gases form a tail, the points that points in the direction away from the sun. Direction away from the sun. Then how it looks? It is visible from the earth. Which one that? Halley's Comet. Okay children, so Halley's Comet, it is visible from the earth, every 75 to 76 years, it is visible only. Then again after 70 to 76 years should go, then only we can see the Halley's Comet. Clear children? It was last observed in the, this Halley's Comet, it was last observed in the 1986. When it is 1986, now again should go 75 to 76 years. Then we can see the Halley's Comet. Clear children? So here you can see the small bodies made of frozen gases, rocks and dust are called comets. When these comets come closer to the sun, the heat of the sun that gases form started to release. When they started to release, you can see the gases form a tail. It's form a tail and that point in the direction away from the sun. Clear children? So children, here you can see the comets. See here children, when it is come closer to the sun, because of the intense heat of the sun, it heats up the comet and the gases are released. You can see this, the gases form a tail that point in the direction away from the sun. See the tail. It is a form of gas. So children, here you can see the comets is very closer to the sun. Just you can see When the comets come close to the sun, what will happen? Just you can see how it's heat up and releasing the gas. So this is the Halley's Comet, children. Halley's Comet is visible from the Earth every 75 to 76 years. Last time we observed in 1986. See the Halley's Comet near to the Earth, which was seen in 1986. So children, next heavenly body is the matter. Something we see, a burning object falling from sky. Just you can see burning object falling from the sun. These are called matters. What they called? They are called matters. They are smaller parts of asteroids. They are the smaller parts of asteroids. And comets that enter the Earth atmosphere and burn, when it enters, this all the matters, when it enters into the Earth, it burns the Earth atmosphere. These are also called the shooting stars. See how it's burning, and they are falling from the sky. Here you can see, children, meteors are hot. They are very hot. When sometime meteors do not burn completely, and these are called the meteorites. What they called? They are called the meteorites. And these meteorites, they strike the surface of the Earth, creating the craters. Just you can see, they are creating the craters on, creating the craters on Earth surface. So they are the burning object. They are the burning object. When this burning object fall on the Earth, then what will happen? The atmosphere will burn. You know, children? Here you can see, children, how the meteors are falling from the sky. They are a hot burning objects. So here you can see, children, when the meteors do not burn up completely, when they do not burn completely, then these are called meteorites. When they do not burn completely, and these meteorites fall on the Earth surface. Here you can see, children, when these meteorites strike the surface of the Earth, it's creating the craters. You can see the big hole there, wherever these meteorites falls. Crater means what? Big hole. Just you can see how it is burning Earth atmosphere. See, it's create a big crater only. That is a big hole. See the matters. So children, here you can see the Lonar Crater Lake has a mean diameter of 1.2 kilometers.
and its average depth is 150 meter. So when this meteorites fall on the earth, see, it's create a big crater. So Lonar Crater Lake in Maharashtra. Just you can see, after falling the meteorites, see that place. Now it's became the tourist place. People are coming and observing that crater. So just to imagine, children, if it is fall on the earth, then we can find the everywhere craters, big big holes only. So children, in today's class we have discussed about the asteroids, meteorites, comets and the meteors. I hope you will enjoy it by seeing these images. So I will stop here only, children. The same thing I will continue in the next class. Thank you, children.